Jai Guruji. My name is Naresh Adhikari. I'm from Richmond, Virginia. And my auntie Bhargavi and my two kids have also come. We do Guruji satsang every Thursday at my home. This goes back to 2004. And I just wanted to share my experience. How somebody who does not believe in God in general, or does not believe in any specific religion, how we can get connected to Guruji. In fact, like how Guruji, you know, make sure that as long as there is a strong desire, as Auntie was saying, within you, how Guruji will somehow, you know, find you and put you in the right path. So this goes back in 2004, and one fine day, my friend with whom I've been working for almost like six, seven years, he tells me in the office, "Hey Naresh, I know you recently had your daughter, your in-laws have come from India, so they might be interested in a satsang. Why don't you come and bring them?" And he knows very well that I'm not into all this spirituality thing, so he was not inviting me. He was asking me to kind of drive my in-laws to his house. And that's when I was like a little bit surprised. I know this person, but I was surprised that he conducts a satsang at his house. So I take my in-laws and my wife and my first daughter, and that's when I first see Guruji, Guruji Swarup in his house. And that kind of really connected me. I cannot explain it, but you know, it was a very nice, very great feeling when you see Guruji's for the first time. And I have been to some other satsangs also earlier. It's not like the first time I'm going to a spiritual satsang. But this was something different. So I went and then attended my first satsang. And then something pulled me every week to to the satsang. So me and my auntie, we both used to go, even though we were having like 6 months old kid. It was winter time, but we just bundled her up and then, you know, took her along with us to the satsang. And that's where my kind of journey started, like my interest towards Guruji, something was pulling me. So this was going on for almost like 7-8 months, maybe 9 months. And I was kind of thinking like, you know, is this it? Like, this is what like Guruji satsang is? Like, I'm going every day, every Thursday, and having a nice langar and then sitting down having Guruji's satsang. So is this it? There's got to be something else, Guruji. And I was just talking to Guruji, just like casually in my car. Guruji, if you are there, if you are God, you prove to yourself, you prove to me that you are God, you are there. Then only this mind will agree, because all along, like, most of the folks, like, you know, we are kind of believe that anything which you can feel, touch and smell, that's what real. Everything else is like, you know, up for debate. So I was kind of just throwing a challenge out to Guruji, like, please help me out, please clear this mind. So that went on, and then I came back to office and I was busy in my office work. And afternoon around 12:30 or so, I went and had a water at one of the water fountain in the office cubicle. And I was just coming back, not even thinking anything, casually coming back. And out of nowhere in office, the huge fragrance of rose completely kind of covers me up. It's not just a faint smell, huge fragrance of rose. And in the satsang, I think Guruji, a lot of people have experiences of Guruji in the rose, in the form of rose fragrance. We have seen in the Divinity of Light. I heard it so far, but I'm a live example where it was like immense fragrance. I cannot even describe, as if some 1,000 bottles of perfume somebody has sprayed in front of your face. It's like it completely covers me. And at that moment, something within me kind of tells me, hey, look in front of you. And there Guruji right in front of me walks in the office in the United States in end of 2004 or so. And that's where the definition of God, like like I kind of asked Guruji, you show me, I want to feel, touch and smell. He made me smell the rose fragrance, he made me feel the water fragrance, kind of water mist kind of falling, and smell the rose fragrance, and then he kind of comes right in front of you, and that completely changed my DNA. Because I'm a kind of guy, usually very far away from all these things, and then me coming from, especially from Andhra Pradesh, I have no friends, relatives, nowhere who would be connected to Guruji. So I was like, the more odds are really stacked against me. So I'm a live example where if you have like a strong desire, he will find you, he will come and he will get you. And that has been like the most profound experience I had, which changed my path, which changed my family's path. And I was like, we were very fortunate, like in 2005, we went to Chote Mandir, Empire Estate. And that's where when we first walked in, Guruji was casually seated. He sat on a kitchen, like near the kitchen, there is a small like a bench. He was casually sitting on the bench. So we walked in, we didn't know, we were like totally unaware of all the timings and everything. We just walked in at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. It was supposed to start at 7 o'clock or 6:30. So he was seated on the bench. He saw us and he said, Bhairo, he didn't even say anything. He just like guided us, okay. And we just sat in front of Guruji. There were like three or four people for almost like one and a half hour. He was there. Myself, my wife, we were just like looking at him. And then around 6:30 or so, the Sangat started to come. So Guruji, he stood up and he went inside. And maybe a half hour or so, you know, he came with all his beautiful dress and everything. He's like fond of really wearing nice clothes. So he just came with his all full avatar and he walked in from there. He sat on the Simhasan, and I was seated over there, and I was just wondering, like, I know Guruji is a man of few words, and whenever he speaks very, like, you know, pure Punjabi, which I don't understand. So I was thinking, like, if I go and go to Guruji, if he speaks something, then how can I understand? Like, there's going to be a little bit of a problem over here. that thought came in my mind. I was just, oh, okay, we'll figure it out. Then people started to come, and you know, they did Mata Teke, and then they were like going back and sitting down. So my turn came, I did the same thing, and lo and behold, Guruji speaks in like pure Hindi. Kahan se aaya? And I said, Guruji, main Hyderabad se aaya. Wo kiske saath se aaya? Mere patni ke saath aaya, Guruji. Okay, langar kao, ash karo. And that's the like nice, like he just spoke, and then that simply made my life. Like that's itself, it's good enough for me in this life, which is just his grace and his words and his presence. He just transformed our lives with his completely divine grace. So I'm very fortunate that I was able to come to this mandir for the first time. It was totally unplanned, so we just came, and I'm glad I'm able to share my satsang with you all. Jai Guruji.